mahapon. Ang aking view of candidates, ang aming of course, pag-ingabalay na ba ito, is of course, heritage building, changing lives, embracing adaptive values. This was discussed earlier by Big Salas, I don't have to define it.
Next slide, please.
So this is called Avancenia, pag-ingabalay na ba ito. It was built by Don Fernando Avancenia with his wife, Yolanda Abaha. In the early 1860s, it would take him about 5 years to build that one. This is next slide, please. So we coined the tagline in 2007, where the past is always present at the Avancenia Pamilya Balay na Bato. So,
next slide, please.
Running in the same vein and in symphony with our mayor, our greatest advertising man. So, we invite everyone to discover Avancenia Pamilya Balay na Bato and their journey through history and flavor, where every corner tells a story of our rich history, and every bite offers a taste of our vibrant culture, a living testament to the enduring spirit and delicious traditions of Iloilo. So first citation was in March 4, 2005, with a strong and vigorous support of our mayor, Councilor Lex Tumbas, Architect Tony Santrador, and then Councilor Tuna Sela, the founding member of the ICC-HCC. We were given the citation for the best adapted reuse of the Avancenia Pamilya Balay na Bato. That's how we started. We are an arquitectura mestiza. This is the marriage of our very own icon, the Bahay Tubo, and for other foreign influences. We are still in residence in the Pamilya Balay na Bato. We have never abandoned it. So the collaboration project started in year 2007. We were only near market ready. We were not full market ready at that time. So with a lifetime museum with visual artist Sir Eugene, of course Sir Eugene, thank you so much, Sir Eugene Amarlan, architect Johnny Liwana, and Manuel Tixon, the University of San Jose College of Architecture, UP Visayas Center for Western Visayas Studies, Dean Fernandez of UST, and Senator Lola Legarda, we have accomplished this project, and it took us so many years to do that. The claw of the in-law, ako na. I'm just the in-law. The guest owner is my husband. Diba, ma'am? So, and 17 years in the making, still counting, and spending a little fortune. Now, this Avancenia Pamilya Balay na Bato, circa 1865, is an Iloilo icon and synonymous to the Iloilo. And by the grace of God, we open our doors and welcome over 100 guests every day, Monday to Sunday.
Next slide, please.
On December 15, 2015, we, of course, were marked by the National Museum under the umbrella of the National Commission for Culture and the Arts as an important cultural property or ang mahalagang yamang pangkalinangan. It is a cultural property which has been singled out in the city in the Philippines from among the many number of cultural properties as possessing exceptional cultural, artistic, and historical significance. 13 kilos of brass marker. It took us a while because they changed the font and it is entirely black in black and white. This is the first year na bronze, the 13 kilo bronze. Displayed proudly in the Balay na Bato. Next slide, please. We crafted a vision to be the leading platform of Western Visayas heritage experiences and products. And our mission is to delight the world with exceptional Western Visayas heritage experiences and products through local community collaboration. Of course, in the almacen or in the store or in the warehouse, we still have the spinners of heritage, but a job and have loan, a mother and daughter team. Naging pamitan din namon na mabalik ang amon ng anong kapol, ang nanay niya dati kahapol sa kay Lola Lutina. So these are the products, that's the weft and the warp, and it produces a third iridescent color. I think that's displayed Sir Eugene in our plaza. The weft and the warp, that symbol, that's for Ah, yes, yes, in Israel. It's the wealth and the work of the Tiral, the hand you. I see now Bologna's Patadjo. Some una pa lang ang mga Patadjo. And the UP Center for Western Visayas Studies identified the patterns and the weaves, which of course we shared with our weavers, and we still weave every day. But they have to weave only in the morning and on the abosang hapon, ibang na lang sila. That is really a trend count. They really count the trend.
Next slide, please.
Of course, our signature heritage street, this is also sinabi mo sa Tubalay na Bato, is our Cacao Tableya Espresso, which we grow in our spring room Agri Farm Pibaras, and we were ranked by PDI as the third best cacao beans in Region 6. Why did we do this? This is a product of COVID-19 pandemic. So to have a great stability or claim a single source origin, during the pandemic, we have a lot of employees and staff in the farmlands with nothing to do. And so my husband, career farmer, decided that we should plant cacao. To date, we have planted 16,000 cacao trees. And next year, when the climate change and the El Niño is over, we have 4,000 seedlings and we will grow to 20,000 cacao trees. All of our trees are fruit-bearing. We have been issued by the Department of Agriculture a license for a learning site for agriculture, teaching cacao farmers all over Western Visayas to do it the right way. And do it in a scientific way. You cannot be a teacher with a learning site for agriculture if you are not a scientist. So that's another milestone. Okay, go ahead. That's our learning site for agriculture. Our milestones is, of course, we have grown 5 varieties of cacao. You can grow 1 variety because you need 5 or more so that they will compete and outgrow one another so you get a bountiful harvest. Another milestone, of course, DTI, Department of Trade and Industry, DOST, Department of Agriculture, granted this a loan during COVID. It's a 4.2 million loan, 5 years to pay, interest-free. So we have paid to pay, a portion we have paid, a portion we have paid. So those are our milestones. So this is a DOST Region 6 designed and funded Cacao Tableya Processing Center sa talong ng ibigay sa Camilla Balay na Bato, sa silong of the house. So this is aircon, and then of course, to claim that we are an artisanal cacao, our production is not entirely by machine. We still do the metate. So metate will, of course, reduce your acidity and, of course, your astringency. We still have metate with us. Next slide, please. So we were given a license to operate by the Food and Drug Administration. So we need to say we can export our tableya now. Enjoy the vernacular cuisine. This is a celebration of the Ilongga Heritage Food in the house. So we have reasons to celebrate. The house is now, by reservation, a restaurant. So we, of course, champion only the Ilongga cuisine. It's so easy for us to come up with a restaurant because the Ilongga way of cooking is just the simple way, the hulo. We're not fond of sauce nor gravy. We don't take a lot of inventory, it's to the materials. And we are, of course, supported by our Springfield Agri Farm. We are not a certified organic farm, but we are a compost-based farm. And it is so easy to plant alubate, and of course, all the aquai, and we have, of course, the estivitis. And so we can readily just harvest the farm in Ibaoan and in Pibaras. So we have, of course, been an active player in the city's bid for the UNESCO Award Creative City for Gastronomy. 2 items in our buffet were documented by UP Center for Western Visayas Studies. Our pork, we know all nothing but salt, and of course, our chocolate express. Next slide, please. Okay, so we have entertained a lot of guests. So on a single day, we have about over 100 guests while partaking of our chocolate and bread. Next slide, please. And of course, our sinama, we wrote that, and our periphery, kung pansit mo, lumpia, and empanada. It will be always a memorable dining experience, what to see, what to do, what to eat, and what to buy. Next slide, please. This is the Iloilo River, Palay Hondo to be built along the Iloilo River. This was drawn by the USA Chinese of Architecture, that's the elevation plan of Palay Hondo. And to, of course, level up the events of Palay Hondo, in 2019, we constructed a bed and breakfast, a small hotel, overlooking the river. In the morning, you'll be greeted by the Iloilo River view with the herons and the wild ducks and the golden terns within. So that's the view from the windows. Next slide, please. The Palay is what used to be the pantao, or of course that's the war. We have our own war, where our junk boats would of course take our produce and sell it to the markets. That's the Alwasen and the Curitiba. Excellent reason. This is the Salamayor. And we are of course part of the MSMB, micro, small and medium enterprise. That's why we were supported by DTI, TV, and UOSD. We are employing about 50 staff and farmhands. Our business model is, of course, our linkage with national government agencies. It's a sustainable and viable, and of course, building communities for environment and country with God's grace. That ends my presentation. My time is up.